声音，两片薄薄的声带在喉管里经由气流推动鼓起掌来，这千分之一秒间震动所产生的频率便构成了我们所听到的声音。将这声音的音高和时长以自然的法则排列组合，就创造出了我们所能欣赏的音乐。将这两者相结合进行表演创作的人，就是唱歌的人，简称歌者。我是歌者周曼琪，今晚我将用十首古老的歌曲讲述一个我与歌唱的故事。
从记事起，我的生活就一直被歌声所环绕。起初是爸爸爱唱歌，只要爸爸在家，家里就少不了歌声。而我呢，从能发声起便也学着他唱，这一唱就是20多年。即使离家到国外求学，使我的生活发生了巨大的改变，但唱歌这件事一直都在。歌唱对我来说意味着什么？我们古老的祖先曾说过，言之不足歌之，歌之不足舞之蹈之。我不曾拥有一副灵活的肢体，但却在音乐中歌唱中找到了抒发感情的方式。接下来的这两首歌来自奥地利作曲家舒伯特，他的音乐感情饱满纯粹，对我而言是极为亲切的。我曾在新加坡国家美术馆的展厅里将他的 Du bist die Ruhe 你是安宁带给一位观众，唱到几近落泪，也曾在酷寒的北欧应景地唱着他的声乐套曲冬之旅，感受被寒冷包裹的深沉忧郁。这次我将再次演绎他的 Du bist die Ruhe 你是安宁，以及另一首他传唱甚广的作品 Ave Maria 圣母颂。 Next we will listen to two art songs composed by Austrian composer Franz Schubert. Schubert's sensitivity towards poem textsand the innate ability to put words and music into an intimate fusion have led to the creation of some of the most beautiful songs we have ever had in music history. For what we will be listening to, Du bist die Ruhe, You are the Peace, expresses passionate love with a tranquil touch, while Ave Maria is the prayer, Hail Mary.
Thank you.
在国家美术馆的那次演出对我造成了极为深远的影响。演绎着舒伯特的音乐是一方面，而另一方面则来源于他奇特的安排。我的舞台被设置在一个展厅里，观众是前来观展的游客。每次表演，我都只对着坐在我不远处的一个人唱。我唱着，视线落到对面的观众身上，我就看到他们或眼角含泪，或面带微笑，或眉头紧锁，或东张西望。在我带给他们的音乐中，听者的反应居然这么有意思，这激起了我更大的好奇心，也让我有了更多的疑问。晚期浪漫主义作曲家理查德·施特劳斯似乎在100多年前也曾与我有过同样的探索之心。 Next, what we're going to hear is an up-tempo piece. In this piece, the singer displays character while asking the ultimate question about life. What do we actually know? Presenting to you, Nichts, Nothing, composer Richard Strauss.在这样的探索中，一颗浪漫、多情、敏感的心被打开了。我试探着向这世界伸出情感的触角，而其中最强烈的，当属与一人分享生命的渴望。法国作曲家德彪西在其作曲生涯早期，就以音乐的方式对这样一种情感做出了诠释。朦胧梦幻的意境，飘渺不定的和声，我们一起在音乐中体味那些细腻而滞涩的情感。 Next up, we have Romance, composed by Claude Debussy. In this song, the poet compares the memory of his beloved to the soul of the lilies gathered from her thoughts. Where has their divine fragrance, which brought so much happiness and peace, gone?The fluid melody and supple accompaniment, as depicted by the composer, give this romance its enduring appeal. Thank you. 有人说，艺术往往脱胎于对现实的不满足。我想，或许真是这样吧。因为我们无法在现实生活中得偿所愿，所以我们在艺术中幻想。下面这首歌的歌词来自于法国诗人波德莱尔的诗集《恶之花》中的一首诗。诗人寄情于幻想，希望借着大海的波涛，与所爱之人一起航行至平和安宁的不老之乡。
Next is Henri Duparc's L'Invitation au Voyage, Invitation to the Voyage. This is one of the most famous melodies of all time, composed around 1870. It was Duparc's special role in the history of French songs to introduce a note of depth and seriousness into a genre that had been notably lacking such qualities during the Second Empire. With Baudelaire and Duparc, we traverse the landscapes of the Dutch East Indies. As in all such journeys, where imagination plays the largest part, we find ourselves flying beyond operatic sets of words and canvas towards realms previously inaccessible to the French duo of singer and pianist.
Thank you. Thank you, Manqi and Zewei, for that wonderful performance. As our singer and pianist take a break, we have invited a few guest performers who will now take over the stage and bring you their music. So, ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome the very talented guest performers.
Hello, everybody. How are you feeling tonight? You feeling good? Yeah, nice. My name is Nicholas Zixun, and today I'm the only solo performer invited. And thanks, Manqi, for this opportunity for playing this magnificent venue. Even though I'm a solo player, the piece I brought in has really like many dimensions of sound. For example, you'll be listening to a clear sign of melody like this. You'll be listening to groove. You'll be also listening to different layers of sound. Like, for example, I will be playing this bass line along with kind of percussive instrument like this. Meanwhile, I'll be playing the melody line. Yeah, so hope you enjoyed this piece. The piece is called Sunburst. Thank you. Thank you.
name is Yun Qi, and this is my good friend Yun Yu, and this is my brother Yun Ling. And together we're gonna do an acoustic rendition of my own original song. Yeah, and some backstory about this song. I composed this song actually before this COVID-19 began. And I find this song, the meaning of this song, very fitting for now. Mm-hmm. Basically, okay. So this song is about I will not say it's a sad song. It's actually I would think of it as a very uplifting one. To constantly remind ourselves that who and what are we living for. I know sometimes we are all stressed out by study, by work. Okay, but when the real disaster is coming for us, I think it gives us some opportunity to reflect on our lives and what are the most important things in our lives, be it family or for our lovers or maybe music. So without further ado, let us perform this song for you. And by the way, it's called Annihilation.
Living all behind to grow.
音乐真是一门有趣而又充满魔力的艺术。当我的伙伴们用自己熟悉的语言享受着自己创作的音乐时，我却被那拥有几百年历史的古典音乐皇冠上的明珠歌剧所牢牢吸引。初听歌剧，我既不懂语言也不了解故事，但那都无法阻止我被其深深震撼。人的声音这一乐器在歌剧中居然能有如此强烈的情感张力，如此调动人情绪的戏剧化表达，如此令人震撼的美，我对此毫无抵抗力，一头栽了下去。
Next, we will have an opera aria composed by one of the biggest names in classical music, Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.This is the Spinus aria, Una Donna Quindiciani, a woman of 15 years, from the opera Così Fan Tutte, which means women all do thus. In this opera buffa, a love comedy unfolds as two young men were challenged to take on a bet and test the fidelity of their female counterparts. Despina, the servant maid of the two sisters being tested, is a witty young girl who is proud to know all the tricks and tactics to manipulate all kinds of people around her.
歌剧的舞台仅限于富丽堂皇的歌剧院吗？我并不这么以为。大学期间，我曾在挪威待过一个学期。没有出去旅行的日子里，我都尽量坚持唱歌。雪落以前，天还没有那么冷的时候，我会在傍晚时分走出宿舍，穿过一片荒芜的草坪，草坪尽头是一条斜坡。我顺着这条斜坡而下，半道上向左， 拐进一条小径里，就一头扎进一片稀疏的阔叶林里。这时我的脚边是一条潺潺小溪，身后是围起大草坪的土坡，头顶上是密密丛丛的树叶，面朝不远处的田野，我就这样唱起歌来。这样一方天地，在我唱起下面这首咏叹调时，就变成了18世纪法国某歌剧院的舞台，拥有悲剧命运的女主角在这样的旋律中唱出她对艺术的谦卑与敬畏。
Our next piece is Your Song Lumile Ancella, I Am the Humble Servant, an aria from the opera Adriana Lecouvre, composed by Francesco Cilia. In this Verismo opera, the heroineWho is a famed soprano, was praised by her patrons. She replies to the compliments by saying that she is only the vessel through which the muses of art work their wonders.
感谢音乐， 感谢他一直带给我源源不断的力量，他让我有了表达的勇气，改变的勇气，信任的勇气，还有接受死亡的勇气。就在前年，三位我亲近的直系亲属相继离世了。小时候，我总以为家里长辈齐整健全是件很正常的事情，但后来了解了其他人的情况，才知道并不是所有人都能拥有那种程度的关爱。但分别总是会到来，在自己懂事后，习惯了那么多年的关爱后，这样的离去或许更为残忍。因为学业的关系，在亲人离世时，我并不总能赶回去送他们最后一程，得到的往往就是一句轻飘飘的消息，告诉我在这世上再也见不到这个人。我好像应该悲伤，但事实是我接受得很平静，胸中似乎有些什么，却也化不成泪水从眼眶里涌出。于是我转向音乐，学习了下面这首咏叹调。
Next, we will have Senza Mamma, Without Mamma, from the opera Suor Angelica, Sister Angelica, composed by Giacomo Puccini. In this opera, Sister Angelica, a woman who bears a child out of wedlock, is sent to a convent to repent for her sins. After 7 long years, she finally has a visitor from her family who delivered her devastating news. 2 years ago, her son was stricken with a mortal sickness, and nothing could save him.
Thank you.
这样看来，音乐在我生命中扮演的是这样一个特殊而重要的角色。声音是我最忠实的朋友，音乐是我最亲密的伙伴，他们陪我一起走过困惑，走过孤独，走过迷茫。这最后一首歌，这献给所有我们所热爱着的并深深眷念着的。 Our last piece for tonight is 叫我如何不想她。 How could I not think of her? In 1920, the poet Liu Bannong left his homeland China to study at London University. At that time, he missed his home and close ones so much. It was those intense feelings of longing and love that led to his writing this poem. Once it was published, it fast became a crowd favorite. Subsequently, the internationally renowned linguist Zhao Yuanren composed music to this poem. This melody has since been dearly beheld by generations of Chinese worldwide. Presenting to you our last piece for tonight, 叫我如何不想她? How could I not think of her?
So actually, we prepared an encore piece that will be an original composition by myself for the piano. And this piece is called Magma, composed 1.5 years ago. And this time, Zoe at the piano here will be my voice. And yeah, that will be what you'll be listening to next.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay.
Say something.
Seems like now it's time for me to say something. First of all, thank you all so much for coming in tonight and spare with us this 1.5 hours. And second, I need to thank all these wonderful people who have given me so much support on stage. And actually, this idea to have this recital is kind of a personal or even selfish one. I just wanted to share the music that I have learned for the past 4 years with more people, and I'm interested to find out what their reaction will be like. Then, because of this idea, I have brought so many people on board to really do this recital. And I'd say in this process, I have received so much selfless help from all kinds of people around me. First of all, I need to thank my vocal coach, Dr. Cha. Where are you? I can't see you, sorry. I'm not wearing glasses. Yeah, so Dr. Cha has been so kind that he voluntarily coached me singing for 4 years. And even before this recital, he has had lessons with me every week just to tune my voice to the primary condition so that I can complete the recital. And I'd say you have built this instrument in me that allows me to express all those emotions I have. For that, thank you so much. And I also want to thank my choral conductor, Professor Nelson Kui. I also don't know. Okay, hi. Yeah, so it's actually by singing in Professor Kui's choir that helped me realize how magical music can be. And it's always with your choir that have constantly remind me that how wonderful it is to make music with friends and to share it with others. For that, thank you so much. And the third person, okay, Mr. Lai, my voice teacher. Mr. Lai, is he here? Hello. Yeah, so thank you so much for introducing opera into my world. It's a fascinating world, yes. And I also want to thank Zoe, who have supported me so well on the keys. And I'd say you have brought out that music in me. Thank you so much. And all these people. Maybe I don't need to say more thank you, right? You all know from the heart. Yeah, and like my parents, everyone who are here and who are not here. All of these people have given me so much support in this journey that I had with music. And without them, I wouldn't be standing here today and presenting this recital to all of you guys. And I think I've said and sung enough for tonight. So I wish everyone a wonderful life ahead. If lucky enough, with the company of music And as for tonight, hope you have a good night of sleep, and bye. Bye-bye. She proposed that we bow again, so. Thank you. Yes, and we need to thank the generous support, without which this recital would never have been possible. So we'd like to thank the generous support from Mr. Jiang Lianghui and also the National Youth Council. Yes. Thank you so much. And hopefully more people will do their part to contribute and support the art and music. Yeah. I think we should call it a day. Thank you.